Reel away. I'm ready.
So last season there was like a more mystical element. What did you tease about like the tone of
the season? This year will be much more, it'll be much more gritty, much more return to our roots. I think Stephen has said in the press a lot that that was the goal. And it's definitely our goal as well, is to kind of come back and make it more of a crime show the way it was in season one. More villains of the week, more kind of close-ended stories, and magic will still be there because we've introduced it now, and just, you know, we're going to honor that that was what we did in season four, but it's not going to drive story the way it did last year.
Can you tease about the new photos that Oliver has seen your face for the next season?
Well, a couple of things. I think, when we come into the season at the top in 501, there'll be a new kind of element of crime in the city, which will be led in some ways by Chad Alcoma's character. There will also be a lot of, we really want to explore the mafia and kind of the criminal underworld that we've hinted at various times and throughout the years, but this year we want to really get into that and go, and that will also take us into kind of Bratva and also tie into flashbacks more since we will be in prison.
What can you tell us about those Bratva flashbacks?
We're super excited about them. I mean, everyone's been waiting 5 years to do this, and we're thrilled. It's going to be great. We really want to delve into the world of Bratva, really see how he became a captain and what his experiences were there, and to make it as, again, like kind of gritty and visually different and dynamic as possible. So it's. And we're also going to tie them in much more with the present day stories thematically. So you'll feel the kind of, there'll be a little more, synergy between the front and the back stories than we've had, I think, in past years.
Will the ship and Jason's back be brought up again at any point? Like, will she have to face those struggles? Because that's what's keeping her walking. So is she going to have to struggle with that at all?
Oh, that's a good question. We don't have any immediate plans to do that, but it is new technology. I guess you never know. Hopefully not, though. We like what's new for us.
And what can you tease about where we can find all of our Jason's relationships?
Well, in the past, one of the things that I know Elicity is a very sort of lightning rod of controversy on the internet. We left them in a very ambiguous place at the end of season four. And I think we'll get some clarity in the first 5 episodes, particularly in episode 5 of season 5. But by the same token, one of the reasons that relationship happened is because we were really right into those characters and right into Stephen and Emily. And we're going to do the same thing in season 5. We're going to kind of let the characters tell us where they want to go, and we'll see where we end up.
Now that the world has kind of expanded as much as it has, how do you balance that expanded world and also really focusing on your own characters?
It's a tricky thing. I think Arrow in particular, being the first of the tour and also being in a way the most grounded. I mean, when Mark, Nathan, and Drake first came out with the show, there was no superpowers. It was meant to be very grounded, very gritty. And season 5 is an attempt to sort of really answer that, and it is about balance. I mean, we have to deal with Flashpoint, but we're going to do it in a way that is very much part of the Arrow universe. And I think the way we deal with meta is the same. We have to honor them if they're there, and we want to because it actually opens up storytelling possibilities for us. But by the same token, we don't want it to change that much, of the DNA of the show. So it's a tricky balance, but I think it will be story dependent. If we find the right story, and we want to bring in a meta, or we want to talk about Flashpoint, we will do that.
So we've known that Arrow's had a 5-year story from start to now. So now that we're entering into season 5, Connor, how far ahead do you guys look at as far as story goes? Is it season 6, season 7, or is it just up in the air?
It always sort of, you always feel a little bit, are you tempting fate? You go, oh, well, we're talking about season 6 now. Well, you don't have a pickup for season 6, but you don't want to talk too far ahead. But you always are thinking about it because we always know where we're going to end up. We usually know at the end of the season, at least where Oliver and our big bad, or the villain of the season, where they will end up. So you're sort of always thinking, well, what is the most dramatic ending for the season? And that does raise questions about season 6 and beyond. So you're sort of thinking about it, but it's very fluid because it changes. Every episode sort of changes the shape of that to some extent.
Okay.
Yeah.
So each season kind of has like a definitive theme. Like, what can you tell us about season 5?
The theme this year is definitely legacy, and it's really going to revolve around Oliver going back to his roots, as we've talked about, and also answering that question of, you know, he got into this because he wanted to right his father's wrongs, he's going to be evaluating, has he done that? And what is the best way to do that? Is it as the mayor, or is it as Green Arrow? And while he's struggling with those questions, everyone else will be also similarly thinking about their own legacy. Felicity, Diggle, everybody will be kind of in that same headspace of, is this a hard life they've chosen? Do they want to keep doing this? And when they do, what is that? What kind of legacy is leaving behind for themselves, their memory, and their families?